Hello everyone, I welcome you all for this today's session on design of valley curves on roads. Myself Ashok Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand, the Institute of Technology, Solapur. Learning outcomes of the today's class: at the end of the session, students will be able to design the length of valley curves. In the previous session, we had a discussion on design of summit curves. Now we are going to design the valley curves. So vertical valley curves, a convexity downwards, so that is known as a valley curve or a dip or a sag curve. Again, we have a two gradients, minus g1 and plus g2, connecting these two gradients. We are connecting these two gradients by a smooth valley curve. The design of valley curves will similar to the summit curve, but the factors we need to consider: comfort condition, driver comfort condition, side distance criteria at valley curves, and to locate the cross drainage structures at the lowest point of the valley curves, that is the drainage aspects. We need to keep this all the factor while designing the length of valley curves. Valley curve forms where descending gradient meeting another descending gradient. The calculation of the deviation angle is, that is the algebraic difference between the ascending or descending gradient. Here both are a descending gradient, hence n equal to minus n1 plus n2. Here another one, descending gradient meeting ascending gradient, that is minus n1 plus n2. The calculation of the n is minus n1 minus of plus n2. So here n is, the deviation angle is n equal to minus of n1 plus n2. In this case, a descending gradient emitting a perfectly level ground, that is n2 equal to 0, that case n equal to minus n1. Here ascending gradient meeting another ascending gradient plus n2, so that case n equal to n2 minus n1. Now think for a moment and try to pause the video over here and give the answer for this question. Is there necessity of providing a transition curves on valley curves? In summit curve, we have seen that there is not requirement of transition curve, but in the valley curves, is the necessity of going for a valley in the transition curve in the valley curve or not? If so, yes, give the reason for that. Write down the reason for why the transition curve is required. If not, give the reason for that also. I hope you are able to write the answer for this question. Let us discuss about the correct answer for this question. I say the requirement of transition curve in the valley curve is required. The reason behind the requirement of transition curve in valley curve is the centrifugal force along with the gravity and sulfate acts in the downward direction when vehicle is moving at higher speed in the valley curves. So when centrifugal force and gravity acting downwards, this causes the additional pressure on the wheels, that is tires, as well as the suspension system of the vehicle. So for that reason, when centrifugal acceleration exists, then we need to introduce this centrifugal acceleration gradually. So for that case, we need to have transition curve. Otherwise, it causes a discomfort to the passengers and driver and might be sudden jerk and safety aspects. So for all the reasons, we need to have transition curve on the valley curves. So next question comes, what is the ideal shape of the transition curve? We know that the three shapes are there for the road construction: lemniscate, spiral and cubic parabola. Because the deviation angle is smaller in the valley curves, the path followed by lemniscate, spiral and cubic parabola are similar. But among all three, we select for ideal transition curve as a cubic parabola, because the reason is the setting out property or the calculation of the arithmetical properties, calculation of the coordinates, cubic parabola is selected as the ideal transition curve. Suppose if you are going for a transition curve, so it will be designed as a fully transition. So there is no summit, any circular curve in between the transition. So in this case, we are designing the entire length of the valley curve itself a transition curve. Another factor we need to keep it in the mind is the side distance criteria. Here, during the day, both the vehicles can each see well in advance. So there is no problem of any side distance or visibility during the day. So both the vehicles can see each other in the day. But during the night, when the vehicle is driving, during the night, so there is a lack of the sight distance during the night, or the lack of visibility during the night. So the entire the visibility depends upon the headlight of the vehicle and what is the inclination of that headlight in the upward direction. So this is happens because there is no any no any there is no nothing street lighting is provided at the valley curve. There you must depends upon the entirely upon the headlight side distance. If you designed this curve as a very steep valley curve, you might be observing this headlight is going to fall on the lowest point of the valley curves. So that case, the visibility is going to be reduced. You can't able to see the opposite vehicle or front of the vehicle which is going ahead. So this much distance I must keep it reserved for designing the length of the valley curve. So this headlight, at least this distance, headlight side distance should be equal to the stopping side distance. So here the stopping side distance is also called as headlight side distance. To locate the drainage point in the lowest valley curve, to have a cross drainage structures at the lowest point, to avoid the stagnation of water at the valley curves, we need to locate that lowest point. So what is the point of the valley curve? It is at the lies on the side of a flatter grid and side of the flatter grid are nearest to the tangent, first tangent. So that is x1 from tangent to the lowest point, that is given by L into square root upon n1 by 2n. So where n1 is the first gradient, n is the deviation angle, and L is the length of the valley curve. Now let us go for the finding out the length of the valley curve for stopping side distance criteria. We need to consider two criteria here. One is a comfort criteria, that is with respect to the centrifugal acceleration, introduction of rate of centrifugal acceleration. Second condition is with respect to the stopping side distance. So here again, the length of the valley curve is designed keeping in the factor that the when the vehicle is at the lowest of the lowest point of the valley curve, will have a minimum side distance requirement. Let us see that the h1 is the height of the light above the road surface, that is taken usually as the average height, that is h1 is taken as 0.75 meter, and inclination of angle, the headlight angle in the upward direction, that is taken as alpha value. So this alpha value will be taken as approximately 1 degree. Now for a parabolic curve, because we have seen that the ideal transition as parabolic, the equation of the parabolic is y equal to ax square, where a is nothing but n upon 2l and y is h1 plus s tan alpha. So this coordinate the s comma h1 plus s tan alpha. So put that y value and x is nothing but the stopping side distance or headlight side distance. So taking all the values, so n square l equal to n square upon 2 into h1 plus s tan alpha. Put the h1 value as average height of the headlight is 0.75 meter. And alpha it is taken as 1 degree. So in this case, the equation will become L equal to n square upon 1.5 plus 0.035 s, where s is the stopping side distance. If the stopping side distance is to be required to be calculated, so we know that how to calculate the stopping side distance, that is 0.27 vt plus v square upon 254 f. So in this case, we are neglecting the both the slopes of on either side. So neglecting the slope, we need to calculate the stopping side distance. So this is the equation when length of the curve is greater than s. Second one, when length of the curve is less than s. So in this condition, again, let us take that the vehicle starting at the start of the tangent point or starting of the valley curve. So in this case, with the geometry of this figure, h1 plus s tan alpha equal to s minus l by 2 into n. So again, l equal to 2s minus 2h1 plus 2 tan alpha divided by n, and put the h1 value as 0.75 and alpha as 1 degree. Again, equation reduces to 2s minus 1.5 plus 0.035 s divided by n. So in this case, we have to determine first, assuming the first condition is l is greater than s, calculate the length of the curve. In this case, your length is, the assumption is correct. We need to adopt the whatever the adopt the derived length of the curve. If in this case the length of the curve is less than s, so that case we have to use this equation to calculate the length of the curve. So another one, the factor we are considering is a comfort condition to introduce the centrifugal acceleration. We need to find out the what is the length of the curve with respect to the comfort condition. So let us see that the LS is the length of the transition curve. R is the radius of the curve, and V is the speed of the vehicle, and C is the allowable rate of change of centrifugal acceleration, that is taken as 0.6 meter per second cube. So LS, that is length of the transition curve, to have the centrifugal acceleration, we know that VQ upon CR, where C equal to V square upon R divided by T. So T is know that the time to travel the entire length of the transition, that is given by the length of the transition divided by the speed. So put the T value over here. So equation will become C equal to VQ upon LR, R LS equal to VQ upon CR. So this is the equation. Now further, to calculate the radius of the curve, that is LS upon N, that is length of the transition divided by the deviation angle. And in this equation, put the your R value. So R value, if I put the R value, that is R equal to NS upon N. So LS equal to NV cube upon C into LS, or LS square equal to NV cube upon C, or LS equal to square root upon NV cube upon C. So final equation, the LS equal to NV cube upon C upon whole to the power of 1 by 2. So that is the total length of the transition curve. So this is the half of the length. So we need to multiply by 2 to avoid to get the entire length of the transition, that is 2 times of the LS. So LS equal to 2 into NVQ upon C whole to the power of 1 by 2. In this case, V is a speed in meter per second. Now we need to calculate the length of transition curve with respect to the side distance and comfort condition. So both we have to calculate and adopt the higher among the side distance or comfort conditions. These are the references I have prepared referred for presenting this presentation. Thank you.